How y'all doing? I actually have an assignment that I have to get done, right? That's like the main reason I'm hopping on the bus. I just got a notification from the mail center. It's for my clothes that I ordered. But yes, your girl ordered some clothes, one of which being my birthday dress. I'm really excited to go and grab those while I'm out, and then I'm gonna come back and try it on. Yeah, I'm actually about to make another purchase, either on the bus or when I get back. I'm about to place an order on Amazon for some decorations for my party. Not my bun. What the hell is my bun doing? Girl, what? I'm doing like a club theme for my 21st birthday. So I am having to order, well, not having to, but obviously if I want to commit to the theme, I'm ordering a red carpet. What else did I get? These cards will get you drunk too, because come on, let's put some games. I have a Gemini rhinestone Gemini letter belly chain. Wait, that's a stomach? It's like a G-string, but it's like chains. Hopefully this letter chain will actually show. Photo booth props for, we won't have an actual photo booth, unfortunately, because those apparently are expensive, but we're just getting like the photo booth props, and then we're gonna set up a ring light in front of my backdrop and just have that be like where we take pictures. We got some VIP wristbands. We got two black cotton shirts for my brothers because they're gonna be my bodyguards, and I'm gonna give them like a guest list, and they're gonna be the ones like checking people in. That's gonna be funny. I got a wireless karaoke microphone because I wanna do karaoke towards the end of the night. I got a memory card for the pictures. And then the last thing I have, because my bus is about to pull up, is I hope these are candles, like the sparklers, because I wanna have like the sparklers on the bottle, like the bottle girls. Hey, that'll be fun. I'm gonna talk to y'all more when I get back. My bus is about to pull up. I am a little nervous because it's sequins, so I'm curious to see how this is gonna look. Girl, I don't want to look cheap. Oh, okay, good, it's stretchy. Ooh, cause I don't see no zippers. Okay. I really don't know how this is supposed to go. Oh my god, y'all, my back finna be out. Like, she's sexy though, I like it. It is long. She's dragging. I'm 5'2", so kind of expected that, but I am gonna be wearing heels.
That's all y'all get.
Avery, would you like to be my bottle girl?
Girl?
Are you gonna be a bottle guy? So basically, depending on how long the party goes, whatever time I decide on, at one point in the party, you'll just come out with a bottle with sparklers, and you just dance like the bottle girl.
I think I might have to pass on that.
You're gonna accept? Oh my gosh, thank you so much. So I'm thinking you and Saray will be my bottle girl slash guy.
Okay. So we're not doing this part anymore?
Oh, we're doing that.
is the 21st of April. I am getting ready to head out to catch the bus to go to class. So basically the main thing that we ran into problems with was delegating funds. With everything that Ching and I had planned to do, because we're wanting to book an Airbnb, which is actually my mom's idea, we realized that if we had to pay for the Airbnb, then we wouldn't have enough money to really pull everything together. I feel like it's gonna be really fun if we could get it and book it and pull it off with the decorations. And for how big the place is, it's actually a really good price, but unfortunately it has a minimum of 3 days and that comes up to like $612. So my mom said that she would cover the venue, which takes a lot of stress off of me. Ching's friend Tina is going to be doing some decoration for me, so mainly the backdrop, a customized neon light, and then a balloon garland. Anything else? I do feel really bad for making my parents spend like even more money for the venue. Push comes to shove, we could just have it at my mom's house, but I really don't want to for multiple reasons. Yeah, we'll see what happens, because we still have to check for availability and then put down a deposit. Ching and I are probably going to work on getting that sorted out this weekend, because it's already April 21st, y'all. Like, my birth month. I call it my birth month. I'm one of those girls. But my birth month is literally in a couple days. Like, what the hell? I feel like just yesterday was April 12th. Like, what was I doing this whole month of April? I really cannot tell y'all. I'm excited. I'm nervous, but excited. Okay, bye. Okay, so the date is April 24th, 2022. Kind of in the thick of it with my work right now. Tomorrow is the start of week 5, so we are coming down to the wire. But I have another birthday update, and this one unfortunately isn't a good one. I went to message the host for the Airbnb, basically to put down a deposit to ensure that we had the Airbnb for the days that I wanted, the specific days that I wanted. On the website, at least, it has this section of like frequently asked questions. In one of the sections, it had house rules. And the house rule section said no parties or events. So when I saw that, my heart sank. I went straight to Ching. And she was like, well, sometimes they put that as their rules, but they let you do it. We basically wanted to check and see if there was absolutely no way that we would be able to have the party there, or if there was a way for us to like maneuver around it, if it had to be a certain amount of people, da da da. And I sent the message and the host got back to me and he said that Airbnb has a strict no party policy. He said that if I'm looking for a place to rent out for a party, that would be like a separate accommodation. And he said that their prices for those start at $1,500 to $2,500. I'm not paying that much money for it, so the Airbnb is not an option anymore. They don't want me to be great. Like, they don't want me partying at the Airbnb. That's the update. I feel like things are kind of just going downhill right now for me. I broke my vlog camera yesterday. I hate to be like, woe is me, but woe is really me right now. Oh my gosh, I'm so miserable. And I started my period today, so extra miserable. But that's my update, so yeah.
So, at that point, we can like, if y'all, because we plan on doing 3 songs, right?
Yeah.
We can do the two fast back to back. And then we're like, okay, y'all really, if y'all want a little bit intermediate.
A little cool down.
Like, if y'all ready for a cool down, a little intermediate moment, y'all can do rubber.
Okay. It looks so like a hot mess. Oh my gosh. So it is the next day. I was thinking about it this morning, like the whole party thing, and I was like, I don't even know if I want to do it anymore, which sucks because I spent money on like getting little things for the party. I don't want to cry.
I don't really feel as excited to do anything anymore. Of course, my friends are still encouraging me to do it, but it's like I'm just not as excited as I was in the beginning, and I just feel like really overwhelmed. I have a ton of work that I have to catch up on for this directing narrative class. I can't help but feel kind of defeated right now, and that may sound like stupid, maybe even to me when I watch this later, like maybe after the party or after the quarter ends, but I can't see into the future right now, so it's like right now I'm freaking out. I don't know. I'm gonna figure something out, but right now I really don't know what my next step is. So I think I'm gonna call my mom because I feel like she'll calm me down and help me relax. So hopefully my next one is much more happy and positive.
What is up? Today is Friday, April 29th. These clips are literally all over the place. I have clips on my phone, I have clips on my laptop, I have clips on my other SD card. I'm actually about to head to Turner to pick up a new SD card. So, but, this is zooming. Okay. Didn't get the things done that I wanted to get done, but it's really whatever at this point. I just want to go home. So I am currently just trying to balance my short film because this quarter I'm taking my directing the narrative class. So that has been a lot to deal with. Once that's over with, I feel like I'll finally be able to breathe. But I've been trying to balance that along with my party stuff. And yeah, girl, it's a lot. We're still not really sure where we're gonna have the party because I don't want to have it at my mom's house. Based on the party itself, I came up with the idea literally today while I was waiting on the bus. At first, I was going to do what I did last year for my 20th birthday, where I had like a little birthday kickback with my friends and then a family, like a birthday gathering with my family. So I was gonna do that again this year, but since the whole rental thing isn't really working in our favor right now, I'm thinking I'll just have one big gathering instead of separating it into two. I was thinking I would have like a little game kickback sort of thing an hour and a half before the official party. My camera stopped recording. And it'll just be my friends. And then we'll have my family members come in around 7:30 and the official party will start at 8. But the issue with that is that I didn't know how I would invite my friends earlier but also have them experience the red carpet and the pictures and like the wristband sort of thing. So then I was kind of stuck with that. I just listened to some voice notes that Chain sent me.
I don't really like how this is framed at all.
She was saying that there isn't really a way for me to mix it successfully without me getting a little stressed out. I have to choose if I want to do like pool and games or if I want to do like a more formal event where people dressing up and it's like the club theme that I was going for. And honestly, I don't know because now that's a new decision that I'm having to make. I don't really feel like the whole club theme goes with any other age. Like I feel like it's so appropriate for 21. Although I do like the element of the pool because before I left to come back on campus, I bought like some inflatables off of Amazon. I'm gonna get some input because I'm a very indecisive person and I'm gonna need some help. So I'll see y'all in my next update.
I think we should just walk in normally because since the song goes so fast, it's like it immediately go.
Yeah.
So it's just like, it's like hey. Nasty but classy. I'm working bad, me. What my bad is looking for an act. So I'm thinking maybe we can do it like a little pause and then bye bye. That would be
easier.
Okay, you want to stop. As soon as she say nasty, it's nasty. Tongue, tongue, body biting. It's that little stupid dance they be. That little dude that you doing on TikTok. Yeah, yeah. You're doing that. Go that. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Ah! Okay. Okay, so let's try that one more time. Da, 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 da. Classy. Working bad. Bad. I'll work jobs. I have a job. I'll work jobs. I have a job.
Damn, wait, why y'all looking at me? I'm here. Wait,
do it again. I thought you.
Damn, job.
You
know,
ooh, I like that.
You don't like. But that might be hard for them. Pay me for it. Cause I really want that clap part. Cause I want heels clap. I really want that. Yeah. You don't like to take a hike, pay before suck your slot.
Yes.
It's your fave, Kristen. Today's date is May 18th. I'm not going to my music video class tomorrow, so my weekend basically starts tomorrow. I'm going to make my last few Amazon orders tonight. My mom is ordering tents and tables for the party, which she good because I was low-key gonna have people stand around and eat. I didn't even think about tables. I accidentally deleted one of my updates, and so I might have said this in that one. I was thinking of putting rose petals in the pool because I extra and I just think it looked cute. I have people confirming. The green checks are ones who've confirmed, and then I have red X's for people who said they can't make it, and then red question marks for people who on the fence about it, like they haven't confirmed but they aren't saying that they can't make it. And then people who don't have anything next to their name haven't said anything to me. I have 14 official confirmations. I am on and off about my dress. I don't know what it is. Like, I don't, okay. Because I bought like sticky bras because I don't want to, like, my whole back is out in the dress. So I don't want to wear a bra and have the strap showing. So I got like sticky bras. But they're not really working the way I want them to. I went through a phase yesterday and the day before where I was like, what if I just get a whole new dress? I'm just gonna get this to change into because I can't dance in that dress and it's kind of long even with me wearing heels because I'm short. I hope it looks cute. That's my little update. I'll catch y'all on the flip. Okay, this is where we're meant to be. Dancing tomorrow for the heels class, and it's locked. Like, the frick. Second to last rehearsal. We don't really know where we're going to do the dance because niggas been locking the movie room and we couldn't get a studio at Kreitz. Secondly, Amazon is really playing with my spirit right now because I ordered rose petals and they delayed the package until June 13th. I'm not even gonna be in Savannah. And I had to order a new package and hopefully it gets here before we're ready to start dancing.
Just how pretty it is. Damn, I can't even decide
to do, bro. They really don't want us to win. So what if I were the one to take you for the dance? I mean, they didn't
decide this for the dance. Okay, okay.
But they also have some diesel
in here, too. No one's scared. They're probably got the wires running through the
wall. You know
what I'm saying?
Oh.
They got this over here.
It is
blocked.
Yay!
It is Kristen.
Yay!
Look at this quality.
Pose, photo shoot, pose, pose, photo shoot, pose.
walk. For the walk, do we just should we just do the walk for the circle? And oh wait, no, but y'all wanted to do the circle nasty but classy.
But I think it'll still depend on which way each of us start, because Mikayla's facing this way, I'm facing this way, I'm facing mm-hmm. back.
Nasty but classy.
I'm not together.
That's what I'm saying. Do you want to start in my position?
Okay, we're gonna taste test. Here's the drink. Mine is caramel Coca-Cola with coffee.
And mine is vanilla Coca-Cola with coffee. Yeah.
Ooh.
Jesus Christ.
Cheers, cheers.
I taste the coffee.
Me too. That was like the first thing I tasted.
Yeah. It's pretty good. It's not bad.
I like it.
Now, as far as vanilla, I taste, it's like an aftertaste to me. The vanilla is, for me, is an aftertaste.
Yeah, it's like coffee, then Coke, then the flavor.
The flavor, yes.
I agree.
Who ever thought to put coffee and Coke together?
You're onto something. I think we got a raise. Okay. Out of 10.
I'm gonna have to give it a 7. Yes. Okay. Reason being is because I taste the flavors, but I wanna taste my flavors all at the same time. I don't wanna just enjoy that one flavor right then and there. Like, okay, I first taste coffee, now I taste Coke, now it's vanilla. That's just playing with my mind. I want every sip to be the exact same. Mm. And I wish it could be just a little bit more sweeter, because when I first drink it, it tastes... Yeah. Because when I first drink it, it tastes sweet. Maybe yours is different than
caramel. Yeah.
But when I first drink it, it tastes sweet at first, and then after that, the aftertaste is like the vanilla, but it's like watery. So,
oh.
Yeah. Damn, but it's not bad. It's not bad.
I give mine a 8.
Thank you for coming to our TED Talk.
See y'all in the next one.
Bye.
Bye.
I'm your teacher, Miss Hughes. But you can call me Miss Sexy. All right.
Oh, funny. What'd
you say?
We're sexy.
Okay. That better be the only thing that come out your mouth. Because I could have sworn I heard Miss Slut. So we said movie room. We're trying to aim for the movie room.
Yes, correct. That's the top one.
You know what? I see why teachers don't write on the whiteboard no more. This stuff is hard. What's the next plan? Bernard?
Bernard.
What is the plan for the movie room tomorrow?
Plan.
My man. That's so ugly. Ignore. What is the plan for tomorrow?
Oh, this would make a great dolly. Wait a minute.
I'm telling you, right? Look. We can use that as somebody to record, like, drag the chair when we did. Ooh. Let's do a practice test. You know how to be freestyle.
Like, I said what I said to you, like, you got a nice ass.
What the? You saw that too? Yes. What is that? It's D-Day! Right now, it is 4:09. I just got out of a group meeting. And we have, let's just say it's 4:00, so that'd be 5, 6, 7, 5. Oh my gosh, I have an hour and a half until we meet up to do our final rehearsal before people start coming in. Oh my gosh, I did not realize how quickly that time was coming up. Okay, well, there's that. Right now I have like a raging headache and I have no clue where this headache even came from. Hopefully I'm able to pick it up before people start coming in. But in terms of how I feel, let's talk about how I feel. Other than the headache, I feel okay. Like, I don't feel too nervous, which is interesting. I'm excited. Like, I'm really excited. I'm trying to keep, like, a positive mindset about it. I think it's gonna go well, though. Not even I think. I know it'll go well.
Yes, Mekayla did that first.
Yes.
We're here. About to start setting up.
There we go.
Yeah. Yeah. Dong 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 dong.
I didn't even feel the whole thing.
We probably should have got two.
I think first let's get the LED light situation.
It's so pretty.
Why should I hear it?
Ooh.
Okay. Is your mom and this is so good. We good there.
Ooh.
We're
gonna have to yeah, we're gonna so they can see it. This is sexy. Oh. Okay, so this is what we have, and it just reads, "Hey Baldies, quick question, who's going to be in Nassau and available on June 10th, 2022? Swipe up and let me know if you're in town or not, and we'll go from there." So, I just want to see, like, who's going to even be in town, because if they're not going to be in town, then what's the point in sending an invitation and, like, the details and stuff? This is just, like, a quick way to ask everyone, at least friend-wise, who's gonna be there. I'm so nervous to post this and I have no idea why. Ah! I sent it. Okay. I'm gonna go get some food and I'll update y'all later when I look more decent. Okay, bye. Vlog?
Yeah, Drake! Drake!
Oh, that's wild.
Y'all can say hi?
Hi. What's up?
I'm feeling the vibes right now. I wanna cry.
I currently have a music video that I have to edit for my music video class. I feel really, really good. Of course, I got a little anxious a few moments leading up to my birthday, and that usually happens, but I got overwhelmed with, like, all the messages and the calls and, like, I don't know. Concerning my party, the last day to RSVP is tomorrow. I have to start packing. I haven't started packing any of my boxes yet. I low-key feel like I might need to get extra boxes. Y'all gonna see me start packing between today and tomorrow, because I have to have everything packed up between today and tomorrow. The time that they have down to pick the packages up is between 10 a.m. and 4 p.m. which I was talking to Mekayla about this, because she is the person who recommended this storage company to me, and we was talking about how it's so stupid that they have the last day of classes as the day that they come in to pick up people's boxes, and it's from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. Like, that is such an awkward time. I need to schedule a COVID appointment because I have to take a COVID test before I go back. So it's just a lot going on. I'm gonna finish editing this video and feeling good for my birthday. So talk to y'all later.
I just want to let you know how much I love you. I love you. I love you. And like I said once, let me say it again. I thank God for sparing my life to see you reach 21. You were my baby.
This one person, if there's one person I'm gonna cry for, it's my mommy, y'all. Like, oh my goodness. I miss my mommy so much. Oh. I'm still editing this music video for my class. I'm still trying to decide if I even want to go to class today, but I've just been like responding to a few messages. Every single birthday I get like emotional when I read people's messages and like just taking time out that day to wish me a happy birthday and to like just send me their love. Oh my gosh, I'm such a pansy.
Happy birthday, God bless you. Even now, I pray you live to see many, 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 many more years. Take care, love you.
Oh, y'all. Oh. It's getting ghetto.
Morgan, I was gonna ask.
That would look interesting, just, you know. You should want to try it.
Awesome one take. I think you could.
Oh gosh.
Continue until someone hesitates or repeats a word that someone else has said. That person drinks.
I don't know my cheeses.
Gouda.
Cheddar.
Provolone.
Swiss.
Monster.
Mozzarella.
Three cheese Mexican from Kraft. Starting with you. Take turns naming a dog breed. Schnauzer.
Doberman.
Wiener dog.
Poodle.
German Shepherd.
Pomeranian.
Golden Doodle.
Golden Retriever.
Doodle.
Pug! I wanted a pug for so long.
Husky. I would really like a husky.
Oh, husky. My brother wanted a husky.
I've never had a dog in my life. Like, why are you having such a hot dog?
My dog was half poodle, half Pomeranian, and I said both of those. A wiener dog.
I already said that.
You did?
Yes. Wiener dog.
I don't remember that. The tapestry is down, so now it's real.
The bed is disassembled. The tapestry is no longer there.
Going to confession, desperate for redemption.
Right now it's 5:34 and I am so stressed beyond belief. Like, I can't even. I have to go to Home Depot to buy like one or two boxes so that I can just pack one medium-sized box instead of having to pay for three small boxes. My storage price was at $731, which was outrageous to me. So I'm trying to like mix and match boxes so that it would be less boxes. Looked up CVS COVID testing only to be told that there are no appointments available today within a 100-mile radius. I'm trying so hard not to like break down. I wanted to do CVS because there's a CVS near Home Depot. So I was like, okay, that'll just be like near each other. But I might have to go to the urgent care. Okay, so they open at 8 a.m. Home Depot opens at 6 a.m. And then the people will be here to start taking boxes as early as 10 a.m. Oh my gosh. But yeah, I'll catch y'all a little later. Right now it is 8:00 in the morning. Still haven't gone to sleep. I'm starting to feel like how I felt when I pulled that all-nighter last year when I was heading home. Like I can't even describe it. I just took a shower, ate breakfast. They had banana French toast at Boathouse this morning, so I got that and some orange juice. When I tell you, this orange juice hitting a little different this morning. But yeah, I'm about to order an Uber so that I can go to Home Depot. And then I have to print the labels. And then I feel like once all of my boxes are taped up, I'll feel like so much more relaxed. Packing has never been fun for me. I hate packing up my dorm, especially when you have to do it by yourself. It's a lot more stressful. I'm praying to God that these prices ain't outrageous because it's only $8. Perfect. Off to Home Depot. Ooh. And I'm about to like shift some things around because I'm not paying $731 freaking dollars. So yeah, a girl is stressed. Not having a good time. My phone's about to die. The bus is saying drop off only. Silver South and Silver North passed me, seeing me at Expert Care, and now I received an email for my COVID test, but the file is saying that there are no files to show. So let's just pray that the actual document opens up on my laptop. But I'm pissed.
Short pots to help you lift the things.
It's okay. I'm a strong, independent black woman.
That's it, girl. You go, girl.
Y'all, I'm back on the rock. I know she missed me, y'all.
Aww. I do.
In so long. Okay, cheers. Oh,
actually
I'm still not speaking that loud because my roommate might be sleeping, but I have it connected to my speaker. I wish it was a little louder, but I think it'll work. The way my hair laid, it looks like, why is it doing that? Anyway, I just wanted to quickly talk about my struggles with this party. The mic is probably annoying y'all anyway. This is the mic without the speaker. I think it's a little louder with the speaker. Let me tell y'all how I got scammed. It wasn't really a scam. I kind of knew, but I did. Okay, let me explain. For storage, they're powered by U-Haul, and they come to the dorms and they pick up your boxes, store them, and then they drop your boxes off in September, which is when like the school semester would be starting up. Well, school quarter would be starting up again. So I feel like in terms of adding transportation onto storage, the price might be a little excusable. But my bill for storage, because y'all saw me pack up the boxes and everything, it came up to $710. And they did the transaction either today or yesterday, but I checked my bank account today. Now I'm down to like $96 in my bank account. And what is $96 gonna do for me? I don't wanna sound like, oh, that's a little bit of money, but so now I'm a little nervous because I don't know how much money I have on my other card, and I'm scared that like I won't be able to do everything that I wanted to do. I wanted to hire a videographer, which is gonna be $150, but I don't know if I want to anymore. I have my own cameras and I film, I go to film school. I would hope that I could do that. But the only problem with that is whenever I host a party, I never get footage of it. If it's any birthday I want to document for sure, it's this one, because I feel like this is the first birthday that I've really gone, I wouldn't say all out, but it's a bigger budget compared to other birthdays that I've had. It's the first time I'm doing, well, technically the second time actually, that I'm doing a birthday with friends and family, because usually I do a day for friends and a day for family, but I'm combining it. So it's just like gonna be a lot more people. This is the most people that I've ever invited to a birthday party, period. So I'm scared that like I'm gonna run out of stuff, but I don't wanna think like that. Between makeup, hair, and nails, ciao. I know for sure that I wanna get my nails done. I have to get my nails done. Hair, I wanted to do like a low ponytail, like a slick back low ponytail, just sexy vibes, grown woman vibes. But I don't know if I'm gonna be able to do that anymore, because one, I don't know where to go to get that done. It's nothing difficult, it's literally just like feeding in the hair, but I don't know. So there's that.
And then makeup. I have someone to do my makeup, but that's like just more money that like, I don't know. I feel like right now I have to decide what I want to do. That's how I feel right now. That's my little rant. Just in a bit of a financial push and pull at the moment, because that storage really ran me up on breaks. Like, I was not expecting that. Right now it's 12:19. When I tell y'all, it has been a hell of a week. Basically, my body has been breaking. I think that was Monday when I got like really freaking sick for no reason. Wednesday, go to the dentist. Oh, I'm only here for a couple fills. Ah. She has to do an x-ray on me. It's a huge cavity at the back of my mouth. I have to get a tooth extraction. Oh, the extraction itself wasn't too bad. It's just my tooth is being very, very stubborn. So he ended up having to like pull at it a lot. Yeah, I think like some of the apparatus scraped the roof of my mouth. And then from the numbing needle that he had to put in, my throat literally felt like it was closing up. And it sucks because yesterday, I had meant to run a lot more errands yesterday. That just didn't end up happening. The only thing we really did pertaining to the party was go to Variety Disposable, I think that's what it's called, to get like plates and stuff. So yeah, that brings us to right now. But a bit on the fritz about my hair, I still don't really know what I'm doing with it. Your girl is stressed. I have this leftover hair from when I did box braids, like red ombre box braids. I was thinking we could just use these leftovers. God is good that I ended up having like a good amount of hair to work with for that. And then it also works out because I'm wearing red, so, and everyone else is wearing black. So it just fits. I'm getting my nails done tomorrow. I have my appointment set for 1 p.m. and I don't like blowing my hair out with my nails done. I'm stressed and I can't do this no more. Honestly, I didn't think it was gonna be this long when she had first had them on. And then she's doing them and I was like, these kind of long for me. But I still like them. I want it.
Oh, why you acting like you gotta wait for it, honey? I know I've been in your head like shea butter, honey. You go out and tell your friends that we ain't none. They be in the group chat knowing that it ain't 100. Tell your ex-man, brush up on his openers, cause I'm in California trying to put you where the ocean is. Hit the text late like you just now opened it. Yeah, I believe that. Oh, and I know you think you're still on the low, but I heard how you feel from everybody you know. Oh, you're just crossing and you're trying to keep it to yourself. Oh, mama, I want it, just let it fall. If you tell me that you want it, baby, it's a good deal. Oh, mama, I want it all. How you scared of making plans?
Oh,
what?
Give me transformation.
Wow. Yeah. Give to me the shirts. You like them?
One day,
your mommy. Nice. Thank you. Yeah, your mommy eat these up. I ain't gonna lie.
Hey, put it in a G cal. I just wanna see you with a spot round. Hey, you ain't gotta tag me. I can meet the arm in the background, babe. And I know when you're working as a hostess, they be trying to let you out late. But how late? Cause I'll be at the next place calling a date.
So, this is my dress. I'm not staying in it the whole night. I'm changing. But this is what the dress looks like. And also, I got like nipple pasties because this is a backless dress and I can't find them.
Oh, mama, I want it, just let it fall. If you tell me that you want it, baby, it's a good deal. Oh, mama, I want it all. How you scared of making plans when your friends are calling me your man? How you pull up in the pants and you say you don't even want to dance? You tell me that you want it, baby, it's a good deal. Oh, mama, I want it, oh.
Ah! I am kind of freaking out right now. You outside?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm coming out now.
We're just gonna take a quick second. I've just been going, literally since waking up. I do have phone calls to make. It is currently 6:01, and I am freaking out. I'm about to do a mask and throw on some eye patches before my makeup appointment.
Oh my gosh.
I have to be heading out for my makeup appointment soon, but I did a group session with the girls, so I don't think they're done yet. And my mommy rushing me to like shower and get out, but it's like, sis, I don't even think she's ready for me. So I have just let MJ in, my cousin MJ, to set up the DJ, like the DJ section. Tina is outside doing decorations. It's almost time, y'all. It's really literally 6:04. People have an hour to start coming in. I don't know how I feel. Like, I feel nervous, but it's like a good nervous. Like, I'm excited. The moment we have all been waiting for is finally here. Then I had Janae print the t-shirts. Y'all saw me when I gave her the t-shirts to print for my brothers to wear. So she said that they should be heading out by 6:30, so that's good. But I still have like decoration stuff to do, so I'm kind of like freaking out. And none of the girls are answering me. So that's like making me even more anxious, because I don't know when people are going to be done with their makeup. So it's like I need to know when to leave. Should I call? So as I'm editing this months and months later, I'm finding it necessary to do a voiceover to kind of better explain what's going on, because this is really like where things kind of fell apart. This was another reason why I was so hesitant on editing this. Not only was it like a crazy amount of footage, let's start there, because y'all see how long this freaking video is. Another thing that really kept me from editing this was it's also bringing up emotions of like not really regret, but I think maybe regret is the word, because it's crazy how one little decision affected the entire night. And there are also a lot of things that I planned that did not come into fruition, y'all. Like, it's just ridiculous. I was really trying to do everything myself, and I think I should have definitely asked for help. That and the fact that a lot of this setup could have been done the night before, and I feel like I should have done that too. But I was also like really going through it the week of, so I don't know. Happened this way for a reason, but this is such a hard pill to swallow. So I'm gonna try to explain this in as little words as possible. The person who I had do my makeup, really nice girl, by the way, really sweet, really, really, really talented. I knew from jump that I wanted her to do my birthday makeup. I messaged her and she said that she could do my makeup and she would give me like a birthday discount. So I was like, okay, bet. But then she brought up the option of doing all of my friends' makeup, like a little group of me and my girlfriends for like a group rate. But I felt really bad for not even like bringing up the option to my friends, because my makeup artist had given me that option to pass on to ask if they wanted to do it. And so in my mind I was like, okay, she already asked me if we wanted to do it like that, so let me just ask my friends, see if they even down to do it. They ended up saying yes, and I was like, okay, maybe this could be like a cute little moment, cute little vibe. I could probably bring in like some wine or apple cider or something, and it could be like a little pregame type of thing. That's where my mind was at. My makeup artist, she sent me time slots for everyone. These damn time slots, because as y'all can see, I have the screenshot in the video. The time slots start from 3 p.m. I wanted people to start coming in by 7:30, and I was gonna do my entrance at 8. Please keep those times in mind. Essentially, no one was available to make the 3 p.m. time. So I think we were talking about it in the group chat, and I messaged my makeup artist. I'm like, well, nobody's saying that they are available to make the 3 p.m. Can we like push it back a little bit? So we ended up deciding on 4, I believe. So my friends go to my makeup artist, they're getting started with their makeup, da da da. Basically, long story short, it took a lot longer than I guess everyone was expecting. We were just very much behind. By the time it was my time to go to get my makeup done, only one person was done. Basically, everyone was just behind, and I don't blame anyone in this situation, because maybe I just shouldn't have introduced that whole group thing. Some of my friends couldn't get their makeup done because they didn't want to come in after me, and so they let me hop in the chair and get my makeup done. I did not get to my party until 10 p.m. y'all. My entrance was supposed to be at 8, and I didn't get in until 10. And what made it even worse was that
that whole thing kind of threw me off mentally, and so I just felt frazzled, honestly, the whole night. I feel like I could not get my stuff together, and it sucked because I feel like I couldn't really enjoy my party to the fullest. Now, obviously, when y'all see like the official clips and how I edited and whatnot, it's gonna look like we had a blast, and we did. I really just had like way bigger expectations for this party, and it kind of flopped, in my opinion. My friends and my family gonna be like, Kristen, you freaking out, you doing the most. That party was like, it was good. For me and my expectations, it just wasn't, and that's just me being real, because this video doesn't even encapsulate everything that I did to really get this thing together. That's the tea. Like, that is the gag. Like, this video ain't even the half of it. From this video alone, y'all could see like just how much like time, effort, planning, and money I put into this. Yeah.
Yeah, I forwarded to you.
Hey! Hi! I need to go home, but makeup is done. But yeah, we just gotta get there. So we waiting on Terrell so that we can speed home. Don't speed. But we speeding, period. It's really how I enter in at 10. I have cotton mouth. Oh my gosh, I'm so nervous. I couldn't even find my freaking gems to put on my forehead. I'm in the car. It's hot as hell. I'm nervous. I'm scared. Okay.
Run in the back right quick. Yo, a friend is here. Go in the back.
I'm so...
Walk a little slower, bro. Walk a little slower.
Doing?
I'm fine.
All is well?
Yes.
There we go. You have a message for the birthday girl?
Happy birthday, Kristen. I really love you, and I'm excited to be here to celebrate your big day with you.
Happy birthday, Kristen. I really wanted to be at, like I tell you, I come to turn up with you. Bada.
Birthday, happy birthday. It's your special day. We come to enjoy it with you. Hope you enjoy it.
Hey, Kristen, you come here to turn up. You come here to party. Let's get started.
Hi, Chrissy.
You want to say a message?
What an etching.
Lord,
the connection.
Happy birthday, Kristen. I hope you have an amazing 21st year, because your 20s are for your mistakes. Don't let nobody tell you you're doing nothing wrong. You're doing everything right. So turn up, have fun, and God bless you. Love you.
Happy birthday!
Janae.
Uh-huh. Huh? What's going on?
Message for the birthday.
Hold on, but you can't just pop on me like that.
Yeah, man.
Hold on, start one of them first of all. Like,
we ready then?
All.
What
literally
you mean?
All.
Get us off guard. Hold on, man. You can't just do that, dude. Happy birthday, Kristen. Love you. That's it.
Birthday message for the birthday girl.
Happy birthday. Hope you enjoy it. 21.
Much blessings to more life, the good health, and many success. Happy birthday, Chrissy, coming in from your big bro grandmother. Mwah. Love you.
You know, baby sis, always gonna be baby sis no matter how old she is. All I gotta say is, love me to pieces. You know how the thing goes. Stay doing what you're doing, keep your head up. Don't never stop going for your dream, and painting is always gonna happen for you, baby.
Never met my mom.
You gotta put a message for it.
What's my message for what?
The birthday girl.
Let's see. Happy birthday, Dipsy one. Love you, girl.
Happy birthday, Chris. I'm so proud of you. You're 21 years old. Almost a grown woman. I'm so happy to be here to celebrate this evening with you. I wish you lots more happy, happy birthdays, just like these. And in good health, prosperity, and we're gonna have a lot of fun tonight. All the best. Happy birthday. Love you.
Happy birthday. I hope you enjoyed your day, even though everything isn't going as planned. One of the most creative people I know. Wishing you all the best.
Happy birthday, Ollie. I love you so much. You know, I know today wasn't, you know. But I just hope you have a great day, great life, everything. I miss you so much, and I'm so happy to be here. Love you.
Happy birthday to you.
happy birthday to you. And I'm singing that in my Whitney Houston's voice. Happy birthday to you, Kristen. Love you so much. I am so proud of the woman that you're growing up to be. And I pray that you be all that God has called you to be and you live to see many, many more years. God bless you and love you. Kissy kisses. That's me. Say happy birthday, Kristen.
That's it?
For Kristen.
You're Gordon?
Mm-hmm.
Well, you know I don't talk much, Kristen. All right? I don't say much. So I'll keep it to the point. I love you. Happy 21st birthday. You're finally able to drink. Don't go out of hand while you're away in college now. Please, for the love of God. Please. I love you. Enjoy your birthday.
Chrissy, you're 21. Wow, the time has flown. No more slow wine, Kristen. Well, anyway, I am happy to say I am proud of how far you've come. Keep up the good work. Love you bunches.
You can take this off me, eh?
In editing, eh?
Yeah. Hi, Kristen. Happy 21st birthday. Hope you do well in school and keep up the good work. Love you.
Love you.
You gotta say something.
Let me say something to my baby girl. My last pain. Just want to say I love you. I'm very proud of you. You've grown into a beautiful young girl. However, there are some things that we're going to need to change. There are some things we're going to need to sit down and have a conversation about. Now, I don't care if you get mad with me, but I'm mommy. You can't get mad with me forever because you will never have another party in this life. So we're going to have a conversation. Love you lots. Take care. Continue to be the progressive person that you are. You're doing well in school, and I'm very proud of you. God bless you and keep you and make his face to shine upon you always and be good to you. Everything you put your hands to, it shall succeed in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Take care. Okay. Now make sure y'all put a wig on my head now.
Feelings that my carry. Pull up another body, yeah. I ain't out to nobody, yeah. Pull up another car, yeah. I ain't out to nobody for you. Pull up another line.
Yeah, so I'm flexible.
Ciao. Anyway, so.
Hey, y'all. I am finally about to re-dye my hair. It is actually, well, officially 2 days after the party. I told myself I would do this, so I'm gonna do it. But basically gonna, like, recap the party. It is 10:43. I have quite literally been in bed all day. I will preface by saying the people who I spoke to and Ching spoke to, she said that they said that they had a good time, which is amazing for them. The party did not, I have to cover my face. The party did not go how I planned for it to go. And I know that, like, when you plan things, it's not always gonna go exactly how you want it to go. And that's just something that you have to be prepared for. But y'all, I made such a big deal out of people being there on time. I told everyone, listen, if it's two things that I'm really serious about, it's the dress code and the time that y'all get there. And I end up being late. I already see I ain't dyeing my hair at the same time. I got multitasked. I don't get to the party and I don't get outside to everyone until 10. 3 hours after I wanted people to be coming outside. It literally felt so surreal when I was putting on my dress. I was like, bro, it's really 10 o'clock in the night. Like, that is crazy to me. I'm getting dressed, I go outside, I do my entrance. The entrance was beautiful. And the night was going okay. Like, I was mixing and mingling with people, taking shots, having fun, having a good time. My whole thing is, I really, really, really planned to do a lot of different things. Firstly, I wanted to get pictures with everyone. Me getting there at 8, the sun would have just kind of been setting, it still would have been light outside. Secondly, y'all saw it when I did my haul. I got the photo booth thingies, and I was supposed to have like a little section set up there for people to take like silly pictures of the photo booth with my camera there and the ring light. Bim, didn't get to do that. Thirdly, I had the These Cars Will Get You Drunk game. Y'all, I was so excited to play that game. I'm trying not to like think of it in a negative light. Everyone went there and the people I asked, they said they had fun. And y'all, this is the last party that I'm throwing for myself. I'm not throwing any more parties for myself. If y'all want to do like surprise parties for me, be my guest. I had people there who I didn't even invite. This random like guy from Portugal. At the end of the night, I literally ended up like crying my eyes out. Glad that my guests had fun, and that's great, but. Okay, so it is the night before posting this video, and I just wanted to hop on one last photo booth video to wrap this whole thing up. Yeah, so obviously editing this many months later, and looking back on the whole situation at hand. Sorry if y'all had my laptop fan. My apologies, I'll make this quick. But yeah, looking back on the whole experience, I'm obviously able to laugh about it now. I was a lot more emotional in that last bit because it was fresh off the heels of the party, and I was just so disappointed in how the night had played out. Sorry. But obviously I'm gonna throw more parties for myself. Not my 22nd, maybe not my 23rd. Maybe not my 24th. I'm gonna need a surprise party for like all 3 years consecutively. But yeah, I was being a little dramatic in saying that. I just wanted to say thank you to everyone who supported, came out, donated, helped me, was my therapist, listened to my rants, like all y'all. Thank you so much. And I don't want this video to come off or come across as being just complaining the entire time. Damn, my fan going crazy. I am honestly grateful for the fact that I was even able to host a party for myself in the first place, so I'm very thankful for that. Don't get it twisted. I hope y'all enjoyed. A lot more content on the way, I promise, within these next couple weeks. Baby, get it? I will see y'all in the next video. Stay safe, stay blessed, and I'll catch y'all later. Bye!